What's up, guys? I'm BTC. The Winter Wonderland event returns in just over a week. So today I'm going to talk about all of the stuff you can expect, including the legendary skin leaks. There's a whole bunch of stuff to get to. Let's start with when the event will be returning. It's almost certainly going to be Tuesday, December 11th, and it will run until the end of December, possibly a couple of days into January. In 2016, it started on Tuesday, December 13th. In 2017, it started on Tuesday, December 12th. You're sensing a pattern here, I'm sure. And also, we had that little deal that Blizzard did with Kellogg, where you could buy a bunch of Pop-Tarts and some other stuff, and you would get rewards in-game for Overwatch in the form of extra loot boxes and that sort of stuff. Anyways, that little promotion from Kellogg's runs from December 11th until December 31st, so even if Blizzard extends it a little bit, that's pretty much a guarantee, December 11th through the end of December for the event itself. Moving on, we did get some other information about the Winter Wonderland event confirmed by Jeff Kaplan and some of the other Overwatch devs. So first of all, there will be no new game modes. Maze Snowball Fight will be returning, and also Maze Yeti Hunt, but whether or not they're going to have any kind of changes, we don't know. There might be some minor stuff that changed, or they might just return exactly as is from previous years, but there will be no new game modes. However, one of the maps that's in regular rotation will become winterized. And what I'm talking about is the Hanamura map got all of that snowy theme to it. The King's Row map also got a snow theme. The actual payload itself was changed into Santa's sleigh. And then during the Halloween event, you have Eichenwald and Hollywood, and they change up some of the maps during the seasonal events. It doesn't have any major impact on how you play the map itself. It's just a nice little design change. So they did confirm that one other map will get changed for the Winter Wonderland event. I'm gonna make a complete shot in the dark and put out a guess of Watchpoint Gibraltar. The only reason why I'm picking this is because it's an old map and it hasn't already gotten kind of festive themed for any of the previous events. Now, what map do you think is gonna get winterized? Let me know in the comments down below. Make your own guess. Moving on to the more fun stuff, the leaks. This has been happening quite a bit recently. It happened with the Halloween event, it happened with the Summer Games. For whatever reason, Blizzard puts the achievements for the next event on the PTR. I don't know why, but they've been doing it. So this one is no exception. We've got three new achievements for the upcoming Winter Wonderland event. Two of them are for Maze Snowball Fight, and one is for the Yeti Hunt. And even though the sprays aren't included, you can see that there's the little box there. So there definitely will be a spray for each of these achievements. Now let's talk about the really good stuff, the legendary skins. We do have a couple of leaks for these as well. It seems like one is absolutely confirmed, a second one very likely. So we'll get to that in just a second. First, let me show you the big Excel sheet that I have. So this is what I use to track all of the character skins that they've gotten from all the different events. So this is the main one, and then you have another one here. This is just specifically for the Winter Wonderland event, so where I can tell who's gotten them in the previous years. And then this right here is the most recent year, so starting at last year up until today. And this gives me a good idea of what they've been getting over the course of the year, and that kind of helps determine whether or not they're going to be more likely to get something. Because, for example, Doomfist right here has three legendaries this year. So the chances of him getting a Winter Wonderland one is pretty low. Now, he hasn't gotten any Winter Wonderland event skins at all, but because he got three legendaries already, kind of unlikely. Not impossible, but pretty unlikely. So that helps right there. And then this last one is a pretty interesting one. I just made this one in the last day or two. So this is showing how long it took from a character's release until they got their first extra legendary skin. I'm not counting epics in here, only legendaries. So you can see that some of the characters, like Lucio, Tracer, Zarya, they got them right away with the Summer Games in 2016. Reinhardt is unique because he got his first legendaries not with an event, but with the map release of Eichenwald. So anyways, on the far right is the column that you kind of want to look at, and that is how many months from their initial release until they got that legendary. So for all of the standard characters that got released with the main game, you know, there's a big variety. It starts low and then it goes pretty high. But then you have Anna, who took almost 14 months to get her first legendary. Same thing with Sombra and Doomfist, they took 8 months. Orisa's a special kind of outlier because she got released as they were putting out the Archive event, the first Uprising, and her character model was used as one of the bosses, so they just took that and they gave it to her as a legendary. So that's kind of a special thing. But then you look at Moira, Brigitte, and Hammond. Moira took 4 months, Brigitte took 1, and Hammond took a little bit over 2. So it really has been sped up quite a bit. The new characters are getting legendary skins a lot faster. Now, is Ash going to get a legendary for Winter Wonderland? I'm kind of leaning towards no, but I wouldn't be surprised at all if she got a legendary for the next event, which is the Lunar New Year. Now for the leaks, we have one for certain and possibly another. The first one we definitely know is the Figure Skater Legendary. This was accidentally included on the official Play Overwatch website. Now we saw some of the ones from the Halloween Terror. All of those were confirmed. They were added to the game, so we know that these leaks are real. We just don't know who the figure skater is. I mean, it could be anyone. I kind of originally thought it was going to be Lucio, but the thing is, Lucio already has a couple of winter-themed skins. They're his normal ones, the legendary ones, they're hockey. So I don't think they would give him a figure skater one, even though he actually has skates. I mean, it kind of makes sense, but he already has the hockey one. So I think the figure skater one is going to be something for possibly Widowmaker or possibly Mercy. The other leak comes in the form of this shirt, which is on the official Blizzard store. This was available just prior to BlizzCon. There's 3 different characters on it. The obvious one is Zenyatta in the front with the Nutcracker skin. On the left is Widowmaker. This is one of her standard legendary skins, although it's entirely possible they could add a third version for this upcoming event, and they could make like the Ice Princess version or something like that. Maybe they could add some more special effects or something to it, whatever it happens to be. But that is effectively the same as her standard legendary skins. But the one that we want to look at is the top right. So in the story of the Nutcracker, the main villain is the Mouse King. Now, obviously this isn't the Mouse King, it's the Rat King, Junkrat King to be specific. So the thing I want to point out about this is there are a whole bunch of different shirts and hats and all kinds of stuff, Blizzard merchandise, for Overwatch, and every single character that is on any of those pieces of merchandise, shirts, and what have you, all of those character skins are actually in the game. This is the only one, this Junkrat skin right here, is the only one that's not currently in the game. And it leads me to believe that this is almost certainly going to be added as a legendary skin for this Winter Wonderland. I don't think they would put it on the shirt unless they had already planned to put it in the game. Now I'm going to go over my predictions for Winter Wonderland. In the previous couple events, we've been getting 6 legendaries and 3 epics. Blizzard might be starting a new trend moving forward, but in the past, we've gotten 8 legendaries or more sometimes, so I still like to pick 8 for my predictions. We'll start with Brigitte. She's only ever gotten 1 legendary, and she's been out for quite a while. That was the Shield Maiden one quite early in the year. She did just recently get an epic, but I think she's due for another legendary. The Junkrat one, I've already talked about. I think it's going to be the Rat King. For Mercy, she hasn't gotten anything for any of the Winter Wonderland events, so I just think she's kind of due for something. She also really hasn't gotten much this year either. I think it was just the 1 legendary near the beginning of the year. I also think Orisa is due for another legendary. Reaper got 1 epic the first year. It was the Shiver one. It wasn't bad, but since then he hasn't gotten anything. There's a lot of potential stuff that Blizzard could do with Reaper during the Winter Wonderland event. They could give him a Grinch. They could give him the Krampus. I mean, there's all kinds of stuff. Like, they could make, like, the villain of the Winter Wonderland and give that to Reaper. So that's a possibility. Symmetra also has been kind of lacking in the legendary department. event. She's gotten a couple for just the anniversary event because it seems like they don't really know where to give her a legendary, so they just kind of put it there. But I think she's due for a Winter Wonderland one. Widowmaker also could get one. I think either Mercy or Widowmaker could end up getting that figure skater one. Or maybe Widowmaker just gets another variation of that kind of dancing ice princess thing. And then Zarya also did get an epic the first year, but it was pretty meh. So it's entirely possible she could get another legendary this year. As for the epics, Genji, I think he could definitely get something. He hasn't gotten anything for Winter Wonderland yet, and he did get a couple of legendaries earlier this year, so maybe he'll just get the epic. Reinhardt, again, nothing for the Winter Wonderland as far as skins go. They could give him just some kind of silly little epic. And the same thing goes with Winston. He did get the Yeti one, which we now have for the actual May Yeti Hunt game mode, but I think it's possible that Genji, Reinhardt, and Winston are going to get the epics. So there are all my predictions, 8 legendaries and 3 epics. So there you have it, guys. That's everything we know about the upcoming Winter Wonderland event and my predictions for the legendary skins. What characters do you think are going to get legendaries? Let me know down below. Thanks for watching, and if you'd like to see more, subscribe and hit that bell so you don't miss anything. Also, come hang out in my Discord server and my Twitch livestream. Special thanks to my Patreon supporters. If you'd like to see what kind of cool VIP rewards you can get, check the links down below. And remember, always, always blame the controller, because it's never your fault.